your impression, what did you notice? That your favorite one was the sixth one. Sixth one is what you want to do. But you all are doing the sixth one. There is one person sitting on laptop, everybody is making decisions. So what we have here is a performance evaluation system for all of you. So you will be setting targets for every individual in the team, and then you will be comparing the actions, and if you do well, then you are going to get some bonus. So let me tell you about the matrices that we are using. For the CEO, we use return on sales. So what is return on sales?
Fact
by revenue.
Okay.
So it means that income by revenue. So what? How much money I am making per rupee I am selling the goods in the market? What is my income? Profit per rupee that I am giving you. So that is return on sales. So why is it important?
How do you do the company?
Yes. So
that's
and that is why it is going to be the matrix for the CEO. Because it is his or her responsibility that the maximum returns are on every rupee that you are earning. Okay. Employee satisfaction? Whose matrix would it be? Yes.
So why is employee satisfaction necessary?
Productivity? Not just that,
your cost related to people in your organization.
Yes.
And hiring people.
You're hiring people. Or, see, that happens at a middle or junior management. But right now you're at top management. And you also have the problem that we discussed in the fourth diagram, right? Interaction process. Where two or one person goes out and the other people are doing the work properly. If you lose out one person or two people, that's not work well for a company, because it's very competitive market here. You need to have more people who can pitch and can get the ideas properly. Okay? So employee satisfaction. This would be a matrix. Using this you will figure out, okay, if you give a lower rating, because everybody has to give their rating, then you figure out, okay, can these people and how to rope and how to make them work along with us. Market share. Whose responsibility would it be? Marketing, head of marketing. So how do you calculate market share? Just whatever you sold divided by total market share. Now, do you see, we have done three only, do you see any conflict between ROI and market share?
You want to increase market share, generally you have to reduce the price, which reduces the revenue. So if the revenue is increased, then how much
revenue is? Okay, can you repeat again? Okay, let's put it to the market share. Market share equal to units sold
by
total price. Okay. And ROI is equal to okay. So now not telling me when what goes up, what other thing goes down.
So the market share will increase, so we have to decrease the prices.
Okay, if market share has to go up,
then we have to decrease the prices.
Then we okay, price will go down.
Yes, so income as well as revenue will go down for the same amount.
Income and revenue will go down the same amount.
So, it will eventually
increase. Now, sometimes revenue might increase also because unit sales are increasing, right?
So, then also, they will also increase.
Yes. So, this is going to increase and this income is going to decrease. And that is going to take it, like, not necessarily always this will happen, but there is a strong correlation. If you are trying to capture more market share, the ROI is going to go down. So how are we going to resolve this conflict? Because CEO has to meet his or her target. The head of marketing has to meet their target. Cost cutting measures. And whose job would that be?
Operations.
Okay. So okay, let's talk about all the other factors and then we are going to figure out how these are all interrelated. Every single thing that you do in the business is interrelated. If all the functions are not working properly, you will not be able to take the company to the level you want. The differentiation that we talked about. Okay, let's talk about successful projects. Who's handling projects here? In your business?
R&D.
Yes. So why is R&D important?
Quality improvement.
Yes, either function or cost or quality. So if he or she is not doing the job properly, then there's a problem.
Yeah.
We are in an area which is the Tata and Yoruba.